Good afternoon. So, it's very hard to see, but just by a show of hands, how many of you have ever heard something along the lines of, or even said, school is terrible? From what I can see, it's a few people. So, why do people say that? A lot of students come and say, school is terrible, it's awful, it's prison, and I could probably go on and on about the negative adjectives they use to describe this establishment. But the question I want to ask is, why? You'll go and ask a teacher, and even though they work here, they'll probably give a good response to it. School is good for the kids, helps them out. But the students say otherwise. So let's look at some of the things that the students say wrong with the school system. Start with homework, the scourge of every student. If a student has 45 minutes in every class for homework, and this is just what, from what I've collected from syllabi and what the teachers have said, comes out to about 3 hours or so of homework. Now, keep in mind this doesn't include extracurriculars, sports, any of that. So let's say a student does have this much homework. They'll get home probably around 3 o'clock, get off the bus, go home, have a snack, and then they either start doing their homework or they wait a few hours. Now, if they did do their homework as soon as they got off the bus, like the perfect student every teacher wishes for, they'll probably get done around 6:30. And that would leave them about 3 hours before it's technically bedtime. And I don't know if any of you have ever tried to cram a job in, time with your friends, your family, eating, physical activity, sleep, going to the bathroom, any other activities that people go about in their days with 3 hours of homework. It kind of leaves a tight schedule. And again, that doesn't leave sports or extracurriculars or any volunteer positions. So what a lot of kids are saying is that they're so stressed out from homework and after-school responsibilities that they don't have time to go out and enjoy life. They don't have time to hang out with their friends or grab a slice of pizza downtown, whatever you youth do these days. Now, another thing that kids say is that it's a lot more about the grades than learning. A lot of teachers preach to the test, I've heard some kids say. You learn what you need to get the A, and then you get that out of your head so you can learn the next thing. We're like sponges. We can't take all the water, and students can't take all the knowledge they need. While you'd like to imagine that a student can cram every single math lesson, every single English lesson, every person in history, all that into one brain, well, doesn't leave a lot of room for much else. A lot of kids don't get enough sleep because they don't have enough time after homework. A lot of studies show that kids need around 9 hours of sleep to be ready for the next day. And as you saw before, there's not a lot of time for that. Now, I went around, just Baldwin, collected about 150 responses from kids just asking one question. Describe school in one word. And while my capacities are limited for asking kids in this school, I was able to branch out to my friends and get more responses from kids in other schools, and I ended up getting about 750 responses. Now, this is me taking the averages and putting the top 10 answers up of what kids are saying school is in one word. Now, once again, a disclaimer, a lot of the words were a bit gruesome, I'd say, and not all of them are appropriate for putting them up on a screen. So these are the top 10 as close to appropriate answers as I could get. Now, with that, you wonder why kids are saying that about school. If you go to a middle schooler and they say school is terrible, then you have to wonder, is there something wrong, or is it that kid? And while, of course, it's easy enough to pin the blame on every single kid that's saying this, if everyone's saying it, maybe there is something wrong with the system. Now, next, we have a Google search. And if any of you have ever used Google, you know that it finishes your sentences for you. It's a lovely little system. And if you search up school makes me want to, or why is school, it finishes your sentences like this. If you don't believe me, you can, of course, go and check. And once again, as another disclaimer, a lot of the answers weren't that appropriate to put up on a screen. And you wonder, why are those the number one answers in most search results on Google? I mean, I'm sure that not everyone in this lobby is going to go up and search these on Google. But it kind of makes you question, once again, why are people saying this? And while I can't get the individual response of every student in every school, we can kind of speculate. It might be that homework, might be that they're getting bullied, it might be because they just don't like school. But the thing is, a lot of kids have to go to school. I know that almost every student in this lobby would rather stay in bed than get up and go through 6 to 7 hours of school. I know I would. And with that, we kind of wonder, why is that? But let's go over to the other perspective, because of course it's not just the students. I went around Baldwin and interviewed about 10, 20 teachers, and a few responses for what is school, what is Baldwin, how do you think the school system benefits kids, you get, surprised to say, positive results. School isn't that stressful for them. It's a benefit for them, helps them out in the long run. But if the teachers are saying that, and of course, if you go to any teacher, they're going to give you a positive answer because it's where they work. If you go to any teacher and they give you this response, and you pair it up with another kid who is saying something completely opposite, well, then you're going to wonder, what's the great disconnect? What's going on in between those? It's not like a complicated game of telephone where someone says one thing on one end and it's different on the other end. But there are a few things we may be able to do to help. While it is difficult for every single teacher to connect with every single student, a little bit more one-on-one time, or as personal as that gets, would be appreciated for some students. I've heard a lot of kids saying it's just lecture after lecture. I don't know really anything about the teacher. I don't know why they always speak in that monotone voice. Or I don't know why they always use this as a filler. So maybe a little time with the students would be better. A lot of kids are saying that they need a bit more free time or activities to do in class that they can do instead of the work in class. And while that's extremely difficult, since teachers run on such tight schedules, a little bit more relaxation or maybe even incorporating a game is what a lot of the kids have said helps them learn a lot better. And while you're saying, wow, this is just another kid complaining about how much school is terrible, maybe there is a little something we can do. Maybe it's time for a talk. Maybe it's time that we all come a little bit closer in school and close that gap between the different perceptions from student to teacher. Thank you.